Hello everyone, my name is Night Slice, and today we're going to be unboxing an iPhone 8 Plus. This is my first video on this channel, and this iPhone is originally pre-owned, supposedly from Amazon. It would cost $185 plus tax. Got a couple other accessories here, but we'll be upgrading from the iPhone 6s Plus to the iPhone 8 Plus. So let's get right to it. So let's start off first with the actual phone itself. So here we go. So yeah, I ordered this phone like a week ago, and it got here pretty fast. We're just opening it like this. So yeah, as I said, this is pre-owned, so it, I don't think it will come in the original box. Yeah, so it's iPhone 8 Plus US version, 64 gigs. $185 was the price of this phone. Alright, so that's what this paper was saying. Alright, so let's get right into it. So we get this box, white cardboard box. This phone in gray because it was cheaper. So inside the box we also get a USB to lightning cable, and then we got a wall charger for USB. Pretty nice. And some Alright, so yeah, so it's telling you if you want to return it, you have to do these specific order rules to erase all the content. So, alright, so we can get this out of the way. Alright, so let's get right into the phone. Look at that. Brand new. So this color is called gray. It feels very good. This sleep. The volume rockers feel good. Right? And the power button, let's see. Alright, there we go. Booting it up first time. So, while we're waiting for this to boot up, let's open the other stuff that we have. So, this, I also ordered it from Amazon. I'll be putting all the links in the description. This is AKG headphones with microphone and volume buttons. So since this didn't come with headphones, I needed some also for college, so I copied these. If you can see it. AKG. I think these are the ones that come with Samsung, I'm not really sure. Let's open these boys up. So it comes the actual earphones, but they also come with a set of other sizes depending on how it, what fits your ear. Then we have these. So, all right. And since I also learned that the iPhone doesn't have an aux input, does this have a screen protector already on? I think it does. Yeah, I think it does have a screen protector on. All right, let's just also finish doing this. So, all this is trash. So we got also earphones here. And also we got the official Apple Lightning to headphone jack. Little dongle, I guess you could say, adapter. So let's open this up as well. There we go. So it just comes in this box with this. And then come with Apple sticker. Oh man. Alright, so it comes with some manuals telling you how long the warranty is and so. Alright. And so we also have this, which we can pop open right here. And now we have it connected to the phone. And that way this and this connect like that. Now you can hear your audio very well. Of course, I'll be putting the description for all these things in the I'll be putting the links in the description for all of the items I bought. Alright, there we go. Then we also got a screen protector, which will, I don't know if we'll apply it or save it for another time. And then we also have, I bought it a case. Yeah, heavy duty. I don't like it being in those flimsy cases and then it breaking. So this case was like $11. Oh, you got stickers? Nice. You got stickers. I didn't even know that came in there. Shark here. So it's telling us how to open it and apply it, blah blah blah. And thank you for purchasing the product. So this is the case. Well, this is pretty sturdy actually. I'm like trying to piece this thing apart right now. Alright, so we're gonna pause the video and I'm gonna pause it so I can finish setting up the iPhone. Oh, this is like a prompt opener. Okay. continue showcasing this iPhone. All right, guys, welcome back. So it's been 4 days already, and so yeah, we've gotten all our accounts into the phone. We fully transferred it. It's pretty fire. I mean, it works just as it's intended. Even though it's supposed to be pre-owned, it's working as a new one. As you can see, we're already on iOS 16.2. Actually, let me check that real quick. Software update. So, as it says here, we need another version. Yeah, so this update contains other different apps, as you could see. I'm gonna be able to download that later. But as you can see, I got my Apple ID ready. All my other stuff, my YouTube is uploaded already. All my recommended stuff. All the stuff I watch is there. My Instagram. It's all there. It's all working. What else? Bank accounts also working. Everything is functional. So I would say that the overall function is pretty fire. Both of the emails, everything is functional. It works perfectly as a brand new phone. The photos, I didn't really have that many, so I just left it as it is. But other than that, it works fine. I mean, let's put a video up to see the resolution here. So, I don't pay for YouTube Premium, so we have ads. But either way, it all works perfectly fine. I mean, I personally, if I was in a budget, I would get this one instead of buying quality for current video, higher picture quality. So it doesn't really let you choose the resolution you want. But calls, messages, everything works good. I tried the earphones. They work perfectly fine as well. The only thing that's not working is the volume rockers on the earphone. They're not working. Well, I don't know why, but I mean, it is what it is, bro. I mean, I'll just go right here and just press it. But yeah, I mean, if you are in a budget and are in need of a new phone, and you just can't afford the 10, the 11, the 12, the 13, or the 14, I would for sure go to Amazon and check this phone out. I mean, it's $185, just the phone itself. It comes with the lightning cable and the wall charger, so that, plus it comes with a built already has a screen protector on, and it's pretty much set, just for you. All you need to do is just buy a case, I guess, so you don't break it from falling out of your pocket or something like that, or anything worse, maybe like a roller coaster or any type of destruction. You keep it safe. It works with, I think, every SIM card here in the U.S. But other than that, it's pretty much fire. I mean, I would say go for it if you're in a budget. I mean, I personally, I like the home button. I know it doesn't have the Face ID, but I just like touch, like pressing the home button to go back, or go into the apps. I like having that feature instead of more going up in the new iPhones where they scroll, you hold the bottom. But yeah, I mean, that's pretty much my review. I hope you guys like it. Subscribe and peace out. Thank